Brothers and sisters, good afternoon to everyone. Today, our Lunch and Learn series topic is very timely as we are about to begin the season of Advent. Advent, as we all know, is the preparation for the coming of Jesus in our lives. The preparation entails the spirit of waiting and longing. While we await the coming of Jesus, we need to examine ourselves and our life journey to be able to put a true meaning of Advent not only during Christmas time but in our day-to-day lives as well. To give light to us about the essence of the word waiting in the context of the season of Advent, we are very fortunate to have with us Father Benjo Fajota. Father Benjo is the former Vice Rector of Shrine of Mary, the Queen of Peace, or the Elsa Shrine, and at present a radio anchor of Radio Veritas, Healing Touch, Friday to Saturday, 11 p.m. to 2 a.m. He was ordained to the Order of Deacon on March 19, 2005, and graduated from UST with a degree of Bachelor of Sacred in Theology. Father Benjo was ordained to priesthood on April 22, 2006. Father Benjo brings with him both pastoral and corporate experience from his previous background as corporate staff and his past appointment at the Shrine of Mary Queen of Peace Church. Brothers and sisters, let us all welcome Father Benjo.
Magandang tanghali po. First of all, I'd like to thank you, all those who generously helped during my mother's hospitalization and the eventual passing on to eternal life. 1 year exactly today, she joined our Creator October 13, the Feast of Our Lady of Fatima. And today also is, we celebrate, for the Augustinians, the birthday of Saint Augustine. Now, my personal patron saint, of whom my life is much paralleled with. Okay, and before anything, I'd like to, of course, you are so much aware what Advent means. No, it comes from the Latin word Adventus, meaning coming. There is someone coming in our lives, and we know that is Jesus Christ. And there are three times that Jesus Christ came or is coming. First, the first coming, which we celebrate every Christmas, when our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ was incarnated and became man. The first coming. The second coming is what we all look forward to, the parousia, or the final judgment, the second coming of Jesus Christ. And the third coming is what we take for granted most of the time. We fail to welcome the third coming of Christ, which is His coming through our brothers and sisters. Every day He comes to our lives, but we don't notice it, we don't appreciate it, and we don't do anything about this third coming. I'd like to start my sharing with this Advent prayer of confession. Okay, can we all together pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. All together, please. If we have spent so much time shopping that we have little time to spend with those for whom we are shopping, Lord, forgive us and give us sensitivity. If we get so busy practicing for the Christmas programs that we forget to think about what they mean, God, forgive us and give us understanding. If we decorate our houses but neglect the inner beauty of our homes, our hearts, O God, forgive us and grant us love. If we are worried about how much Christmas is going to cost us, but have given little thought to how much Christmas costs God. Oh God, forgive us and give us perspective. If we are so consumed with thinking about this Christmas that we have little consideration for the meaning of the first Christmas, oh Lord, forgive us and give us insight. If we are overextended and bowed down with tiredness and long to see your face, Jesus, but cannot find it, Lord, forgive us and give us a new sign of hope. If we are too much in a hurry to realize our potential, our destiny, that we are saints in the making, O Lord, slow us down and give us quiet and solitude. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Sa prayer pa lang, ouch na, no? Sa prayer pa lang, nakokonsensya na tayo. I saw this very beautiful little prayer on Advent Confession in a book by Father William Bosch, no? A homiletics writer. And I also got the idea from him about this theme for our recollection on waiting. There are two kinds of waiting, the active and the passive. And most people very rarely would wait patiently. If you are waiting for someone to arrive, not to pick up somebody from the airport, madelay ng konti, we lose our patience. Some people would won't mind now waiting or be expecting delays. No? They are patiently, they will make themselves busy, bring a book with them, no, so as not to get bored waiting for someone or something. Okay, so I'd like to go back to each part of the prayer to really talk about Advent first. No? So there's the first, the second, the third coming of Jesus Christ. And most of the time, that's why it is a very opportune time to have this Advent recollection this early. Now, so we won't be bogged down with so much rush, no? For the coming days, weeks ahead. We are celebrating the first Sunday of Advent on November 30, no? Last Sunday of November. And it says here, we spend so much time shopping, looking for the best gifts for our loved ones. But the best gift we could ever give them is our present, our presence. That's why we call it a present to them, our presence. No? Nakakalimutan na natin. And the best gift we could also give ourselves, no? This Christmas, to remind us, it's the presence of Christ, the presence of God in our lives. What we are so much hungry for, no? The presence of Christ. And we are asking for the gift of sensitivity. Be sensitive enough, not your loved ones, that what they are really looking and asking for this Christmas is your presence. Kaya nga't nakakatuwa, no? Every time meron akong mga batang makakausap, anong tatanungin ko, anong gusto mong gift this Christmas? Sasabihin nila, kahit po walang bagong damit, kahit walang regalo, kahit walang gaanong handa sa Noche Buena, sana dumating lang ang mama at papa ko. Sana kumpleto kami this Christmas. That's what Christmas is all about, no? Family. And sabi dito, if we get so busy practicing for the Christmas programs that we forget to think about what they mean, God forgive us and give us understanding. Do we understand the things that we do, why we carol, why we donate, why we give these things, old things, old clothings, not to people who are much in need, why we do outreach programs? Do we understand the meaning of this? Okay? So do we understand? No? To understand is to stand under a person. So it requires humility. Okay. Saint Augustine would always remind us that there are three important things for us to be holy, to become saints, to grow in our spiritual lives. Number one, humility. Number two, humility. Number three, humility. Let us remember that. If we decorate our houses but neglect the inner beauty of our homes, which is our hearts, O Lord, forgive us and grant us love. Be reminded that Advent, the color of Advent is purple, the Advent of the time to be reconciled, to turn away from our sins, like during the period of Lent. Pagkulay po ng dumarating ang Lent, ang Kwaresma, araw ng mga panahon ng pagsisisi, pagtalikod sa kasalanan. At yung pagpapaganda natin, no? Outwardly, externally, decorating our houses, but tending to forget to clean our own homes for the coming of our Savior. Pag meron dumarating tayong bisita, naghahanda tayo, pinapalinis, pinapaganda ang tahanan, no? Binabago, nagre-repaint. What about our hearts? No, nililinis din ba natin ito? Pinapaganda rin ba natin ito? Do we go to confession, not during this period, for to be cleansed of our sins, to be worthy of the coming of our Savior? 2,000 years ago, pinanganak na nga siya sa Sabsaban. E baka ngayong panahon na to, Sabsaban pa rin ang kanyang daratnan. If we are worried about how much Christmas is going to cost us, but have given little thought on how much Christmas cost God by the sacrifice of His only begotten Son, O God, forgive us and give us perspective. Baguhin natin yung pananaw natin. Kailangan Pasko eh. Kailangan masaya. Kailangan maraming handa. Kailangan maraming regalo. Kailangan maraming bago. Pero nakakalimutan natin yung pagpapanibago ng buhay, which is more important than outwardly external changes. No? Bakit dumarating sa buhay ng tao na hindi niya na nakikilala ang sarili niya? Dahil pabago-bago ang kanyang itsura, pabago-bago, no? May mga ginagaya, haircut nito, makeup ng ganitong celebrity, no? Lifestyle or dress style. No, meron tayong ginagaya. Hindi na natin nakikilala ang tunay nating sarili. No? Because we have forgotten what Christmas cost God. Christmas is not about Santa Claus. It's not about Frosty the Snowman. It's not about Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Christmas is the birth of a Savior. Ang kapanganakan ng manunubos. Yun ang nakakalimutan na natin. And it cost God the sacrifice of His only Son. Sarap, no? Pag dumating yung mga ganitong panahon na tayo ay, oops, nakokonsensya. Oops, natatauhan. We need a shock treatment para mabuhay muli ang ating katotohanan tungkol sa ating sarili. We might be so engrossed, so consumed, so focused on our work, on our career, we tend to lose the nature of our being. We not only have a material, physical body. What's more important is that spiritual part of our person. Meron tayong kaluluwa. At yung kaluluwa na yon ang mananatiling buhay hanggang sa wakas. Eternal life. No? Eternal life or life in eternity in damnation. Nasa atin ang choice. No, kaya nga, these times are the times that we put ourselves in the right and better perspective. No? Sana makita natin ang katotohanan. If we are so consumed with thinking about this Christmas that we have little consideration for the meaning of the first Christmas, O Lord, forgive us and give us insight. Insight to the true meaning of that sacrifice. God created us out of love, and He wants to save us out of love. God's nature is love, no other than. Kaya tayo, kahit tayo tumalikod ng paulit-ulit sa Diyos, sa pamamagitan ng ating mga kasalanan, paglabag sa Kanyang kautusan, God cannot deny His very nature, which is love. Kaya nga't may mga tao sasabihin nila, Father, I'm so full of sins. God will not accept me anymore. God will not love me, forgive me anymore. Sobra-sobra na ang kasalanan ko. We have forgotten. This is the very reason why Jesus came. To save us, to free us, to forgive us from our sins. No? Nakakalimutan na natin yung tunay na dahilan bakit dumating ang isang manliligtas. God's love is so immense, immeasurable. Mas makasalanan ka, mas mahal ka ng Diyos. The more sinful you are, the more God loves you. And if God loves us, it's as if we are the only person He loves. Ganun tumingin ng pag-ibig ang Diyos sa atin. Parang special, unique, ikaw lang. We will talk of the not so beautiful things that happen in our lives na kung minsan fail us or make us not to accept this great love of God for us. And then, if we are overextended and bogged down with tiredness and long to see your face, Jesus, but cannot find it, Lord, forgive us and give us a new sign of hope. We are always looking, searching for the presence of God to encounter Him in our daily lives. But every day, God gives us these opportunities. He sends us people, no? He sends us situations, events. But do we discover the presence of God? Do we realize God is present in every person? Tandaan natin, no? We were created in the image and likeness of God. So kung meron tayong hinamak na tao, meron tayong minaliit na tao, meron tayong sinirang tao, meron tayong hinusgahan tao, hindi yung taong yon ang ating hinuhusgahan, minamaliit, kung hindi ang Diyos na lumikha sa Kanya. Remember that. If we fail to love other people much as we love ourselves, then we fail to see God in that person. Then we fail to love God in return. Ang dami-daming bahagi ng ating buhay, ng ating pagkatao, ang ipinapaalala sa atin ng Diyos na tayo ay nilikha niya sa kanyang imahin at larawan. Pero ang nakikita lamang natin, yung the material, the physical side of it. Na? Kaya nga, humihingi tayo ng bagong pag-asa. Humihingi tayo na sana mapalitan na ang ating pag-iisip, ang ating pag-uugali, ang ating pagkatao. At kaya hindi natin ito makita dahil sa dami-dami ng ating mga ginagawa, no? That hinder us from encountering the truth. If we are too much in a hurry to realize our potential, our destiny, that we are all saints in the making, slow us down, Lord, and give us quiet and solitude. At ito yung kailangan natin. I'll give you the three S's for Advent. Silence, solitude, and simplicity. Hindi tayo kailangan makibagay kung ano yung meron ng iba. Hindi tayo kailangan makinang na yung ilaw na masaya, joyful externally, kamukha ng ginagawa ng iba. We are Christians. We are children of God. First and foremost, we are all kapit natin. Hindi natin hinihiwalay ang iba. So, I'm giving you the three important things to prepare for this coming Advent. And so, while waiting for Advent, or while waiting for the coming of our Savior, what do? So we wait. Alam niyo, nung second year college ako, kumuha kasi ako ng BS Psychology sa UST, I wanted to go into medicine. But we were 9 in the family. Sabi ng mother ko, hindi kakayanin. No? Hindi na kakayanin ng father mo. Mag-medicine ka. Ang dami pang mas bata. No? We are 9 and I'm 3rd from the eldest. So sabi ko, sige. So mag-work na lang pala ako. So second year college, summer, sabi ko sa father ko, pasok mo ako ng trabaho. Anong work? Sabi ko kahit ano. And he was a member of PMAP, no? The then Personnel Management Association of the Philippines. So meron siya mga contacts sa different personnel, HRD departments. So, sabi niya, kaibigan ko yung personnel manager ng Manila Hotel. Okay ba sa yung mag-waiter? Okay lang, sabi ko. So I worked there. I was a trainee, extra waiter at Manila Hotel for 1 month. Doon ko natutunan yung mga table arrangements. Doon ko natutunan on anong mga utensils, anong mga silvers, china, at mga ano gagamitin. No? So malaking tulong. And I worked, no? For the first time na nag-work ako as an extra waiter. It was the opening of the, I mean, it was parang binalik yung dancing at the pavilion na doon sa kanilang tawag doon na ballroom. No? So there were two celebrities who were the MCs for that night. Ariel Ureta, in na in pa siya noon, no? 1978 yata yun. And then the new Miss Philippines, then Miss Yogi Dominguez. No? Okay, so I was assigned to their table. No? Very first time, nanginginig ako, nangangatog ako. Ako mag-waiter dun sa dalawang MCs, no? The table was good for 10, and there were only 2 occupying the table. Sabi ko, sisiyo. Okay, so, lagay ako ng tubig. No? The first, you put water sa goblets. No? And sa sobrang inig ko, half of the tablecloth was dripping in water. No? Sa sobrang inig. No? Nabasa yung kalahati. They had to transfer. Okay, maglalagay ka ng bread and butter. No? And you were not using tongs. You were supposed to use forks, dalawang forks. Magsiserve ka, you'll get yung butter, ilalagay mo doon sa butter plate. Sa sobrang kaba ko, sobrang hinig ko, yung butter lumusot doon sa dalawang fork. Hindi ko matanggal-tanggal na ganyan. So my supervisor tapped me and said, okay, I'll proceed. Ako na magtutuloy nito. Get back. So, okay. So experience ko, no? So from this, sabi ko, a waiter's work is actually not waiting for the customers to come. When you say you wait on a person, you serve that person. And this is what we do while waiting for the coming of Christ. We serve our brothers and sisters. Waiting is serving. And we have a model, a beautiful model for our Advent season, none other than the Blessed Mother. Remember, while waiting for the birth of the Savior, which was in her womb, for 6 months, silently, for the coming of the Holy One, she was in silence, she was in solitude. She led a very simple life. But then it was not a passive way of waiting. She actively waited for the Lord by serving her cousin Elizabeth. She went to the house of Elizabeth. She walked, she traveled for miles, 7 hills, just to reach Elizabeth. And what did she do? She knew that Elizabeth was of age. She knew that Elizabeth needed help. She also was in a condition that was very risky. But she did not take that as a hindrance. But more so, it was what she gave her strength to serve another person because she was carrying Christ in her womb. Ganon din tayo. Pag naroon si Kristo sa puso natin, doon lamang tayo magkakaroon ng lakas at kababaang loob para maglingkod. Now, we are not passive waiters of this world. We should be in solitude, in silence, communing with God all the time, but we must actively wait for the Lord. As a shepherd, one of our responsibilities is to let our flock, our sheep, go out of the pen. Go, go, go. Ganun ang ginagawa namin. Sinasabi namin sa mga mananampalataya, go out. Yun din ang message ni Jesus Christ before He went back to heaven. Go back, preach to all nations, baptize in each everyone, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And I will be with you till the end of time. Di ba? Hindi pwedeng yung maghintay ka. Okay, nakaupo ka lang. Wala kang ginagawa. You go out. And as shepherds of the flock, that is what we are urging you to do. Go out. You serve your brothers and sisters. Do not wait silently, passively for the coming of Christ. We do it actively. No? So, it will be a balance of prayer and action. That's why during the time, no, when people were asking, bakit binabaliwala yung pagsiserve ni Martha at ang binigyan lang ng papuri ni Jesus ay si Maria yung nagdasal. Actions must be born out of our prayers. Dahil kung yung ating paggawa, yung ating pagtulong sa kapwa ay hindi nag-uugat sa panalangin, it will be merely a social work na hindi nakaugat dahil tayo ay nagmamahal kay Kristo at dahil natin gustong paglingkuran si Kristo sa pamamagitan ng paglilingkod sa ating mga kapatid. We must go back to our original destiny. And what is that? We were created to know, to love, and to serve God. And how do you serve God? By serving your brothers and sisters. Waiting for the coming of the Lord. You know, my mother was operated on October 5. Now, immediately after she was operated on the morning of October 5, she was rushed to the ICU because her kidneys failed and she had to undergo emergency dialysis. Then each day, no, there was a new complication. May suspect po na bleeding sa brain. So, kailangan po mag-CT scan. And so, a neurologist would be asked to interpret the results. Another day, inuupo po mother niyo. Suspected pneumonia or bronchopneumonia. So another, would be professional doctor would be asked, no? So patong-patong na yung gastos, hindi pa sinasabi sa iyo yung totoo. And you see your mother suffering so much, and you cannot do anything but pray. And then you realize that prayer is all you need. Yun ang nagpapalakas sa'yo eh. Yun yung nagpapatuloy sa'yo. Nagbibigay sa'yo ng hope para ituloy mo. October 13, we decided to have the respirator of our mother cut off because she suffered a heart attack the night before. Sabi ko sa father ko, Daddy, it's morally right for us to decide. Kasi the doctor said, without the respirator, mommy cannot breathe on her own. So, extraordinary means na lang yung respirator. So we decided, no? Nakakatuwa nga, no? April 13, Monday, Feast of Our Lady of Fatima. Noong morning, nag-text ako sa father ko. Ako nandun sa ICU sa labas. Father ko lang sa bahay pa. And after I texted him, dun sa message na I sent him, I saw the date, I saw the time, 8:22, and then the day 10:13. 8:22 was my mother's birthday, August 22nd, Feast of Our Lady of the Salve Regina, or the Queenship of Mary, and then October 13. So I knew that day would come. Ito na, and true enough. No? So Marian devotee ang mother ko. No? So she was blessed to have a birthday on the Queenship of Mary, and her passing to eternal life on the Feast of Our Lady of Fatima. So, masarap din, napakiramdam, na, and you are consoled and relieved that you know that your mother is in the Father's hands. No? Masaya, though you saw her, how she suffered so much, you were so helpless, wala kang magawa. No? Pero habang nagdarasal ka para sa kanya, no, we were continuing to massage her feet, which gave her a lot of ease and comfort. On the 11th Saturday afternoon, I was alone, no, with my mother during the visit. Sabi ko, Mami, mag-rosary tayo. And then, we started the rosary. She could not make any sound. No, so, I prayed, I believe. No? And then the Our Father. Pagdating this Our Father, she raised both her hands. So, she was still lucid, no? Nandun pa rin, nakakapag-isip pa siya, nakakarinig pa. Then when I was saying the Hail Marys, she kept on opening her mouth. No? Pero walang sound, as if praying. And then during the part of that rosary, I saw her mouth opening more widely. No? Mas malaki yung bukas. So I placed my hands on her chin. And then she lowered her lips, kiss my hands 2 times. And that was my last memory of my mother. So parang during the 9 days, nanado siya sa ICU. We were hoping against hope that she would still recover. We were waiting for the answer of God to let my mother have a miracle for she to be healed now and to go home. Sabi nga nung sister ko the morning, di bali, Mami, paglabas mo rito, nasa mas magandang bahay ka na. Because they wanted to transfer my parents to a better place. Pero nung sinabi ng sister ko, what struck me was, of course, Mami would be in a better place. Na, andun na siya. So we waited. We waited for that time that God would hear our prayers. But God decided that there will be a better way, a better time, a better place for my mother. And we accepted that. And we thank you also for being part, no, of that time that we were grieving. You consoled us with your prayers, with your help. At yun ang nakikita ko. No, God worked differently. Differently as we think. Iba ang perspektiba ng Diyos. Iba ang pag-iisip ng tao. Iba ang standard ng Diyos. Iba ang standard natin. But if we can keep on hoping and trusting in the Word of God, then we will find the joy, the peace that we are searching for during Christmas. Nung bata ako, every time we would be celebrating Christmas, laging may kulang sa puso ko. I would be feeling Christmas externally, but deep down, I never felt joy and peace. Laging may kulang. Until 1995, I was asked to work for the Catechetical Ministry of the Archdiocese of Manila. Sabi nila, Benjo, meron ka namang background dati sa theater. But hindi ka mag-join kasi may concert, first ever concert of the priest in the Archdiocese of Manila, yung Wow Buhay, Hi Buhay. No? And that was December 1995. So as early as September, October, we were already rehearsing. So sabi ko, sige. And you know, I never received anything for my work. The concerts were held December 4 and 5. No? That Christmas, I had no money, I had no regular job, I received nothing from that service for the concert which would benefit the catechist, but I felt that joy and peace for the very first time during Christmas, and because I served the Lord. At ito rin ang gusto nating madama lahat. We would always be searching for peace, for joy during Christmas. Not in the gifts, not in the Christmas parties, not in the celebrations, not in the programs, but it is felt in the heart. No? Yun ang dapat nating madama, ma-experience. We always greet other people, Merry Christmas. But do you really feel that merriness, that joy in your heart that you wish for other people? You cannot give what you do not have. You can only greet someone sincerely and heartfelt when you have Christmas in your heart, when you have Christ in your heart. That's why, no, sometimes we see these words, Mary, M-A-R-Y, then Christ, and then Mass. Mary, Christ, Mass. The true meaning of Christmas. The true meaning of waiting for the coming of Christ. The true meaning of serving. Serving without asking for anything in return. At alam ko, no, yung hinahanap ng bawat isa pag Pasko, matatagpuan natin. Hindi dun sa mga regalo, no, hindi dun sa mga programs, pero nandoon sa paglilingkod. Recently, I guested a bus driver in my program, Healing Touch. And you know what? You know why I was struck with his story when I learned from a friend as a bus driver? No? He was able to put up a Bible study in his bus company. Not his, in the garage. Now with other bus drivers. Wala siyang pinag-aralan about theology. Wala siyang background on philosophy. Meron lang siyang napakalaking pag-ibig sa Diyos. Nag-gather siya ng iba't ibang, ng mga lahat ng mga drivers. Nag-invite siya ng mga speakers. At very regular na ngayon, yung kanilang Bible study dun sa garage. Natuwa yung kanyang amo, yung may-ari, yung mag-asawang may-ari ng bus company. And they were so lenient on his schedule now. No? Hindi siya bibigyan ng medyo late na schedule para lang maaasikaso niya yung weekly Bible studies niya. Naglingkod siya ng napakasimple. Hindi kailangan ng pera. Hindi kailangan ng talino. Hindi kailangan ng kakayahan. Ang kailangan lang, pagmamahal sa Diyos. Pagmamahal sa kanyang pag-ibig. Nagawa niyang maglingkod sa payak na pamamaraan. In simplicity of sharing the good news to others. And I found out that he was also invited, no, by UST, not to be talking among professors and staff this coming, I think it was last week, now for their Advent recollection service, paglilingkod. We cannot serve when we are too much consumed with ourselves. And there are two things that will hinder us from serving with all our hearts. Number one, our attachment to money. Our attachment to money. Now, nakakatakot. Sabihin nila, Father, why do you priest? Are so concerned with our money, with our wealth. In the Bible, there are 500 verses which talk about faith. And there are almost 500 verses which talk about prayer. But there are over 2,000 verses that talk about money and wealth. 16 of the 38 parables, money is not a gauge on our spiritual growth, then you would see how much of this affects our lives. money. Sabi nga ni Pope Francis, people will forgive priests on their emotional sleep. People will forgive priests on their sometimes memory gap. No? And sometimes people, or rather people will forgive priests when they make public sins. But what people cannot forgive about priests is their love for money, their lifestyle. Talk about the kind of priest they are. You talk about the poor, you talk about the church being mas na kumakalinga sa mga mahihirap, pero ang kanilang buhay, makikita mo, no, napakarangya. It's sad, no, among my brother priest. I'm not judging, I'm not condemning. I'm just saying a fact that there are priests who talk about simplicity of life, but you would see them eating in fancy restaurants, having the most advanced, no? The pinakabagong cell phones, mga iPhones, iPads, no? At mga luho sa buhay, even their cars, even their way of life. Kaya't hindi nakikita. When we teach not with words. We teach with our lives, with who we are. No? So second hindrance for serving our brothers and sisters is vanity. Vanity and vanity. No? Or pride. Kapatid niya ng vanity and pride. When I was after my stint with Manila Hotel for 1 month, ang summer vacation was 2 months. No? The next 3 months after my training at Manila Hotel, natapos na, so sabi ko sa father ko, may 3 weeks pa. Gusto ko ipasok mo ako sa talagang hotel, talagang restaurant. So may kakilala siya dun sa Las Palmas Hotel, dun sa Mabini. Hanggang ngayon buhay pa po. Mga 3-4 star lata yun. So I was there. No, andun ako sa lobby restaurant. And then, a foreigner. Bata pa po ako noon. May buhok pa. May itsura. So, meron lumapit na foreigner. Australian. Sabi niya, what's a nice young man like you doing in a restaurant like this? Very spontaneous yung sagot ko. Sabi ko, I'm sorry, sir. I can't help it. Joke. So, sabi ko, paano niyang nalaman na I'm actually a student in a university, sir, sabi ko. And this is just a summer job. Oh, I see. Alam niyo, pero from then, I was looking at myself very highly. Hindi pala ako mukhang waiter. Na? Sabi ko, hindi lang pala itsura kong waiter. So I was very proud of myself. And then I carried on this vanity all through the years. And that was the time pala. And I realized that's the reason why I didn't have satisfaction. I was always searching for something in my life. I felt so empty. Na? At yung buhay ni San Agustin, kamukha ko. I loved the Lord very late in my life. I knew Him. I learned about Him very late in my life. Saint Augustine led a very worldly life. No, ganun po yung buhay ko. And he had a mother, Saint Monica, who prayed for his conversion. My mother was so persevering in her prayers. She made a novena for me 12 years. Kay Saint Monica, not only for me to enter the seminary, but for me to become a priest. And I was so grateful to God the time that I was finally ordained a priest with my mother and father at my side. Approaching the altar, ikakasal na sa simbahan. Ikakasal na kay Kristo. Kaya pag meron nagsabing mga pari, na single sila. Hindi po totoo yun. May asawa ang mga pari. And we would always be faithful to that commitment, to that vocation that we made our promise to during our ordination day, as long as we are faithful to our prayer life. A lot of priests would like to talk about God, but they do not want to talk with God. And so they fail. You would see that a priest is good and holy only if you see that his prayer life is intact, is faithful. And we continue to pray for priests. We continue to pray even for those priests that we hear are not living holy and good lives. The more they need our prayers. We do not judge them. We do not condemn them. We ask them to go back to the source of their priesthood. And that is one of our service to them. Pray for priests. Pray and then do something. You act. Okay? So, may time pa po ba? I think this is the conclusion of my talk, my Advent recollection with you. Simplicity, silence, solitude. We need this to be reminded for a meaningful and joyful celebration of Christmas. And this we await during the Advent period. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you, Father, for that wonderful sharing. So, you have any questions? Share.
Questions? Clarifications? Or anything you might want to add? Or disprove? Or contradict? Huwag po tayo mahiya. Isa lang ang dapat ikahiya. Kasalanan. Pag hindi kasalanan. Yes po.
So, what age were you ordained?
Okay. I entered the seminary at age 38. Eh, hindi po diretso. After philosophy, I went out for 2.5 years before I went back to theology, 3.5 at UST. So, all in all, 6 years lang po ang aking priestly formation, and I was ordained at age 47. So, 2006 po ako na-ordained, mathematics, ayan. 56 na po ako next month. Birthday ka December 1. Hindi ko ina-advertise, ha? It's a fact. Okay po? So, late vocation po ako. Kamukha po ni St. Augustine. Late have I loved thee. Kaya, parallel po ang buhay namin ni San Agustin. Dalawa lang hindi mangyari sa akin. Hindi ako magiging obispo, hindi ako magiging santo. Yes po? Question? Patanungin niya ako, no? Do we need anything or do we need to do something great, no, to serve God? Hindi po. Kamukha nung isang bus driver na, no? Na nakapagbuo siya ng isang Bible study para sa kanyang mga kasamang drivers. At napakalaking tulong ito para sa kanilang spiritual growth, sa kanilang pananampalataya. Okay? Yes, po? Ah, oo.
Personal na question.
Okay, show this. Di po, yun nga po sinabi ko na I was working with companies, different companies now. Pero after 2 years serving or working in that company, I would feel something is lacking, was lacking. I could not realize then what it was. No, hindi ko po ma-realize na meron akong hinahanap, pero hindi ko alam kung ano. So finally, when I entered the priesthood, when I said yes to the Lord, the very first time I stepped in a seminary in Baguio, yung pong ako'y kakaroon ng discernment period, Doon ako nakadama ng, wow, kapayapaan. Ibang klaseng, hindi ko ma-describe na joy, no, na feeling. Parang para dito ako. Huh? I was not referring to the seminary itself, pero doon sa buhay. No? Parang dito ako tinatawag ng Diyos. Pero, opo, nagkaroon din po ako ng girlfriend, yung last girlfriend ko, na may mga plano na kami. Ang alam niyo po, hindi na siya nag-asawa. Okay. Well, hindi rin po nagmadre. No, she became born again. At yun ang reason ko bakit kami nagkahiwalay actually. No, we were already not ano, with the faith. Pero ganun, no? Nagkikita pa rin po kami kasi talagang we started as barkada. Mag-friends po kami. And after we parted, ayun, siguro, sobrang heartbroken siya. Joke lang. Hindi na nag-asawa. Opo?
What should be your reaction if one of your children said,
what should be your reaction? My mother's and father's reactions were like this. When they found out that I was already attending a church other than the Catholic Church, I was bringing home materials now from that Baptist church. They didn't say anything. They did not argue with me because I was thinking, had they argued with me, I would have all the more defended the Baptist faith. But they just kept silent. They just prayed for me. I had a sister who was already with the Pink Sisters at that time. And when I informed her I was no longer attending the Catholic Church, all she said to me was, I'll pray for you. Yun lang. Tumahimik. Siguro during those times, when you see your loved ones searching, questioning, the thing that we could give them the best is our prayers and our understanding. Tumahimik lang. Kung lalo natin kinukulit na yung mga anak natin, the more siguro magiging stubborn sila. And so I can only say how I felt at the time because my mother, my father gave me their understanding, gave me prayers. Very powerful po ang panalangin ng magulang para sa kanilang anak. Napaka-powerful. Don't underestimate the power of prayer. Okay? Meron pa po? Sino pa yung mga walang asawa dito? Pwede pa kayong magpare. Don't lose hope. No, baka God is calling you. Lalo na your talent to entertain people. No? You might be another Father Eric Santos in the making. Okay. Yes? Any more question? Sige po, okay lang kung okay pa sa inyo. Apo.
So, what order are you in now?
Order?
Yeah, I mean
OP. Ordinary priest po ako. Hindi po. Diocesan priest po ako. Wala po akong religious congregation. But since I studied theology in UST, formed by the Dominicans, no, yung UST Central Seminary, I'm also a third order priest of OP. Fully professed. No, pero I belong to the Archdiocese of Manila. Pero pag tinanong nila, sabi ko, OP lang ako. Ordinary priest. Okay. Meron pa po? You can also be OPs. Outstanding parents. Wow. Okay, so kung wala na, then magandang tanghali po. Magandang hapon sa inyo.
Thank you, Father. God
bless.
On behalf of the Living Light community, we'd like to thank Father for his time with us today. Short announcement lang po. The Living Light community next Lunch and Learn series, number 17, will be on December 11, that second Thursday of the month. We will be having a night of music and magic for Gian. Guest celebrities and our very own homegrown talents will be performing. The LLC outreach in Homonhon Island, Giwan, Eastern Samar will be from 14 to 21 January. During the week, LLC will serve 700 prisoners through feeding and spiritual programs, hold a tree planting activity, and conduct a catechism classes and stage a magic show for 200 children at the school site. This will be our spiritual gift for the Pope's visit. The ADB Employee Multipurpose Cooperative supports LLC's project to raise funds for the school construction through a raffle for a cause dub, one for Gian, or Walang Iwanan. Each raffle ticket will sell for 100 pesos. The more tickets you buy, the more chances of winning. Exciting prizes while helping rebuild not just a school, but the very lives of our fellow Filipinos. Raffle draw will be on November 27. Please buy your tickets. That's all, and again, thank you, Father Benjo.
I left put a copy of the Advent prayer para those who would